5-minute bios, short on time, long on info, with George Fritchie. Today, Emperor Frederick I, Barbarossa. Emperor Frederick I was born around 1122, perhaps in Haguenau, what is now France. He died on 10th of June, 1190, in the river Salef in Asia Minor. He was the first Hohenstaufen on the imperial throne and went down in history as a mystical figure, as the sleeping emperor in Mount Kyffhäuser in Germany. But first things first. Frederick was the son of Frederick, Duke of Swabia, in the Salian dynasty, and Judith, a Welf. In his youth, he learned to ride, hunt, and handle weapons. He could not read or write. Nevertheless, he was the best compromise between Salians and Guelphs for the election of the king on March 1152 in Frankfurt. Bishop Otto of Freising called him the cornerstone of reconciliation because he belonged to both hostile families. 5 days later, he was crowned in Aachen. On June 18, 1155, Frederick was crowned emperor by Pope Hadrian IV in Rome, the first Hohenstaufen on the imperial throne. The following year, Frederick divorced his wife Adela after 4 years without children, and he married Beatrix of Burgundy. She brings him the free county of Burgundy in marriage and gives Frederick 11 children. A lot of honor, a lot of enemies. Many people wanted to get at Barbarossa's leathers, and the defense of his rule was to run through his entire reign. The preservation of the honor of the empire, honor imperii, and the associated duty to avenge violations of honor led Frederick into numerous conflicts with the papacy, the northern Italian city federations, and thus half a dozen times across the Alps to subject the rich trading cities in the south of the empire to his imperial authority. There, he also got his nickname due to his magnificent red beard, Barbarossa, Red Beard. Around 1,200 documents from Frederick's reign have been preserved. In 1157, the term Sacrum Imperium is found among them for the first time. The term Sacrum Imperium appears in over 30 documents. Barbarossa thus had the term sacred added to the Roman-German Empire, an emperor's own sanctity. However, without the consent of the Pope. During the Second Italian Campaign in 1159, differences arose for Frederick with the Pope over the duty of army succession of Italian bishops and the powers of the emperor in Rome. They remained unresolved because Pope Hadrian IV died unexpectedly. The tense situation led to a double election and two popes. Barbarossa wanted to accept only one pope, and one who wanted to preserve the honor of the empire in his dealings with the emperor. Cardinal Octavian, as Pope Victor IV, was willing to do so. Cardinal Roland, as Pope Alexander III, had insulted the emperor several times, but never made satisfaction. Barbarossa could not and would not recognize him as pope. A schism followed. Pope Victor and Pope Alexander excommunicated each other, and Alexander excommunicated Barbarossa at the same time. On another Italian campaign, an epidemic brought the deaths of numerous bishops, hereditary sons, and 2,000 knights, and profound dynastic consequences. Barbarossa fled precipitously in the middle of the night, disguised as a horse servant, over the only free Alpine pass. Back in the northern realm, Frederick systematically acquired the estates of Erle's high nobles and thus created his almost closed kingdom north of Lake Constance. Frederick's fifth move across the Alps was followed by the Peace Treaty of Venice in 1177. Barbarossa laid aside the lion-like ferocity, assumed the meekness of a sheep, as the bishop and historian Romuald of Salerno tells us. Alexander III again accepted the emperor as a son of the church. Frederick, in return, recognized him as a legitimately elected pope. Barbarossa used his sixth and final trip to Italy in 1184 to form an alliance with Milan, crown his son Henry there, and marry him to the Norman princess Constance of Sicily. His power now stretched from the North Sea to the tip of the Italian boot. At the Diet of Worms in 1188, Emperor Frederick Barbarossa committed himself to a crusade to the Holy Land, but died in Asia Minor in 1190, shortly before reaching his destination. The Saxon World Chronicle of 1225 reports that Barbarossa wanted to take a cooling bath in the Salif River after lunch. But Barbarossa did not leave the river alive. His grave remains unknown to this day. His rather inglorious death is quickly reinterpreted by historians. According to legend, Barbarossa became the sleeping but once returning emperor in Mount Kyphoisa, and thus the symbolic figure of the national aspirations of a united Germany. Well, he probably slept through the reunification. Emperor Barbarossa managed to unite the sovereigns in his vast empire, from the North Sea coast to Sicily, and to ensure peace. In 100 years of Hohenstaufen rule between Barbarossa and his grandson, Emperor Frederick II, the people experienced a relatively calm and happy time. Well, so much for Emperor Barbarossa, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.